need somebody like me. In this video, gagawa tayo ng index discussion. Okay? So, ito yung index natin right now. And still, sideways since the pandemic. And in fact, hindi pa nga yan nare-recover yung pandemic price of around 8K. And when I browse on communities and forums out there, may mga technical analysis people ako. Lagi na the stock will trade. Diba? Dito daw eh. Dito. So, ito yung ayaw ko talaga guys on the trading community. Diba? Especially kung ibinababad mo sarili mo sa trading community. A lot of people in the trading communities guys are just plain morons or idiots. They don't know how to think logically. They will just open their mouth, come up with some certain analysis based on lines. So, for this index to trade here, dito, mauna sa mga 3K or 4K na to guys, ibig sabihin yan is that the companies need to register negative growth rates consistently, massive growth rates consistently for the next at least 3 years siguro for them to even go back to these levels here. Kung hindi yun mangyayari, don't expect for this index to actually go down here. Let's say, no, company are growing slowly or flattish at these levels. So, a lot of these companies right here at these levels, especially kahit mga blue chips, they're giving a dividend yield of, more than 3%, 5%. Kapag yan, bumaba pa dito, guys, those dividend yields will become double. Do you think na habang bumababa yan, walang sasalo dyan na ano, institutionals? Ito yung ayoko talaga sa mga trading or sa mga communities that are purely technical analysis, things like that. Kapag binabad mo sarili mo sa mga ganong community, magiging bobo ka talaga eh. Because a lot of these people, they're just plain morons. And you should not be feeding your brain with their stupidity, okay? So, here's our blue chips right now, and a lot of them are actually undervalued, okay? And even the main index, a lot of them are already undervalued right now. So, etong nangyayari ngayon sa PSE natin is, in my opinion, are sentiment-driven lang to. So, in the sense na bumababa kasi ngayon yung US index. So, kapag pangit kasi yung sentiment, liquidities are flowing out of the index. So, lumalabas yung liquidity sa index. Hindi maganda yung demand on stock prices. Walang bumibili. So most likely mag-sideways yan moving forward. Now, let's take a look at the S&P 500. Ito talaga guys yung nagbibigay ng bad sentiment right now. Sa ating local index. Okay, so here's the S&P 500 na nagko-correct siya. So first, let's take a look, di ba? Kasi ito yung pandemic dati eh. Ano nangyari sa kanila after the pandemic guys, no? After all those lockdowns. So, hindi sila nag-sideways. In fact, karon sila ng expansion on their market. Eh, no? Tuloy-tuloy sila eh. Meanwhile, tayo naman, PSEI, instead of nagdire-diretso tayo, di pa nakakabawi, instead nag-sideways. Ngayon, ang S&P 500 kasi or sa US, karoon sila dati ng mga policies doon, di ba? About quantitative easing, things like that. Karoon pa sila ng malalaking ano, stimulus packages. So, nagkaroon ng liquidity boom, okay? Dahil malaki yung liquidity na papasok sa market nila, nagkaroon ng multiple expansion sa nilang companies. Okay? Ibig sabihin, yung a lot of those companies, they've traded at higher multiples. Multiple expansion kasi companies doon ay nag-trade at premium multiples even though a lot of these companies here ay hindi naman ganun kalaki yung growth nila during those times. And now, nagkakaroon na ng multiple contraction or the opposite. So, nagko-correct na ngayon, guys, yung kanilang market. So, I have a different channel covering US stocks. And eto, guys, so binavalue ko yung top 100 S&P 500 nila doon. And a lot of these are really overvalued. So, eto na yung dulot ng multiple expansion na nangyari after the lockdown. So, the companies are not growing fast. Di naman ganun nag-grow yung mga companies, but they're not growing that fast. And yet, yung multiples ng companies na yon, they've traded at elevated levels or premium multiples, resulting in overvaluation on a lot of their companies. So, ito yung top 100. And nakita nyo, no? Purong-puro yung red based on my own valuation model. Can just look at the top 7 companies. Apple, overvalued. Microsoft, Amazon, Tesla, Google, mukhang malapit na siya on my undervalued territory. Okay? Nvidia, overvalued. So, a lot of these are actually overvalued, guys. The result of multiple expansion. And now, binabawi lang ulit yan ng market. It's trying to correct. And because of this, nagkakaroon ng bad sentiment and inaabsorb yan ng ating PSEI for now. Ngayon, ang mga pag-reverse nito, in my opinion, is, of course, it's still fundamentals, di ba? If the company will try to improve their Q3 and Q4 and next quarters, the next year, habol at habol to yung kanilang fair valuation growth. So, let's say Apple right now, no, 155. Based on its quarterly growth rate, 93 lang eh, dapat eh. So, ito, kailangan itong humabol dito. Meanwhile, ito, itong 155 na to, I've advised na pababa na to ng pababa. So, ito, habol to, maybe next month, or I should say next quarter, naging 100 na siya. Fourth Q, 120, hanggang sa magtagpo sila sa gitna, hanggang sa maging undervalued na sila, then I think that could be the start of the bounce for this company. Otherwise, this index will keep on going down. What if their growth rates will keep on declining moving forward? Yun yung masama kasi if that happens, eto, bibilis yung ano neto talaga. Mas bibilis yung magiging contraction ng ano, ng multiples ng mga stocks on this exchange and pagbaba nitong index na to, mas bababa. Okay? So, eto ngayon yung minomonitor ko, di ba? So, try to see kung mag-improve tong mga to until pumasok sila on my undervalued criteria, which is yung fair value ko and my quarterly fair value should be higher than its current trading price. So, if this kahit tong ano lang itong top 7 na to, if this top 7 can do that the next few quarters, mapunta sila doon, then for me, that's the initial start of a potential rebound on the S&P 500. So, their index right now is down negative 17.42 year to date. Actually, up to 20% na to eh. Di ba? Few months ago, negative 20% na to eh. Now, good thing is that even if there's a lot of overvalued stocks sa index na to, what you can do is that you can hunt for those undervalued stocks and you put them in your holdings. And ito yung sample yan, guys, no? Merong 19, kapag pinagsama-sama ko sila, guys, no? Year to date lang nila is negative 2.33% compared to the index of negative 17.42%. And the yield is 3.22% compared to the dividend yield right now on the S&P na around 1.5, di ba? Maglalaro lang yan dyan eh. 1.2 to 2% at most siguro, pinakamalaki na yung 2%. Di ba? Na kapag eto, nire-reinvest mo all throughout the year, mas malaki pa yan. And eto, baka ma-offset na tong negative 2.33% na yan. Even in these kinds of difficult market, guys, you can still find undervalued stocks. And you can create a holding based on those undervalued criteria and you have a chance of outperforming the index. So, itong mga to na undervalued na to, for sure, during this time, mga undervalued lahat yan eh. So, ito yung, kung ako yan, ito yung problema na gusto ko eh. Kasi during this time, no, let's say nakabili ako during this time or even this time, na undervalued sila, karamihan sa nila. During this time, di ba, marami ka nang nabook na profit eh. And then dito, nag-aabang-abang ka lang ulit. Or, nirotate mo na sila on these stocks here na still undervalued. Di ba? Ito yung problema na gusto ko na potentially mangyari sa PSEI. Na dito, di ba, chill-chill ka lang. And then, later on, once the nag-expand yung multiples ng companies dito sa PSEI, di ba, pakuya-kuya-kuya ka na lang. Then, later on, magko-correct. Di ba, habang nagpapanik, yung iba, anong nangyari? Mga bugok kasi, technical analysis, mga bugok. So, ikaw, nagbebenta ka na lang eh, and then, nagro-rotate ka na lang ng, ano, ng funds mo. Di ba? Things like that. And, all throughout, you're still collecting dividends and reinvesting them. Di ba? Giving you a chance to keep on compounding your dividends. Di ba? Month per month. Dire-reinvest mo yan, month per month, lumalaki lang yan ng lumalaki. Things like that. So, ako guys, payo ko sa inyo, if you're a very rich individual, especially mga OFW, malalaki pera ng mga yan eh, you find a way how to invest in the US market. Kasi, US itself is a diversification already. A lot of these companies, kapag binili mo, diversification na yan. Let's say Apple, no? Apple, Microsoft, Amazon, Tesla, excluding Tesla for now, Google, Nvidia. A lot of the sales or revenue from of these companies, nanggagaling naman yan sa outside USA. Kunyari, sa Pilipinas, di ba? Bumibili pa rin ng tao dito, mga Apple eh. Microsoft, di ba? Bumibili tayo ng product ng Microsoft. Diba? Asian countries, European, whatever continent that is. Diba? Bumibili yan ng US product. So, that's diversification already. And in my opinion, US will keep on ruling for a very, very, very long time. I think they will control the world for a very, very long time. So, mahirap silang padapain in my opinion. So, we have the dollar as the reserve currency. A lot of countries are begging for US dollars, okay? And commodities are trading in USD. So, kapag affected ang US, guys, affected lahat. That's why US is very powerful country. Mahirap yan padapayin. Ang magpapadapa lang yan is if there's a world war and pagtutulungan yung US and mawawasak yung US, then I think that's the time that there's a new world order. Sinasabi nila is China. China is fast growing. China will overtake. Guys, China is a paper tiger. And there's a lot of issue brewing in China right now. So we can just take a look at the main index of Chinese. One is the HSI. Okay. And you can see here that, ayan oh. Guys, ito yung main index ng, ano, isa sa main index ng Chinese. You can see na 2007 is the housing crash, okay? The Great Financial Depression na nangyari 2007-2008. Guys, hindi ba sila nakaka-recover up until now? Sabihin, hindi confident ang mga Chinese on their own stock market, di ba? It means capitalism is not working in China right now. Another main index of the Chinese is the CSI 300. And it's the same thing, guys. This is the great financial crisis caused by the housing bubble 2007-2008. Up until now, hindi ba sila nakaka-recover, guys? Hindi ba nila nabibreak yung kanilang ano? So, capitalism is not working in China. People in China is not confident in their stock market. Yan yung ibig sabihin yan. Now, let's take a look at our PSEI. Mas maganda pa yung PSEI natin eh. Ayan o. Oh, oh. 2007-2008. After that, record-breaking. Bull run yan, guys. ano, 2009 to 2018, bull run yan, tuloy-tuloy, guys. Ngayon lang tayo nagpapahinga ulit. Diba? So, that's the reason capitalism is working in the Philippines. So, SPY lang yung ano eh, talagang madugas kasi ito eh, di ba? Mga stimulus package, mga loss na ginawa nila. Ngayon, bumabalik lang sa tunay or nararapat na index level, okay? And that's it. That's my discussion for the index endings and quarter of 2022. So, take note nyo yan, guys. Dito nyo lang talaga yan maririnig yung mga kanyang klase ng information. Kasi, I'm more of an investor. I put my money where my mouth is. I'm not that typical content creator like these other clouds out there. That's what separates my channel from them. Kasi sila, they're focused on entertaining people. They're focused on pitching their products. Diba? If you want to lose your ass in the long run, keep on losing money, then keep on listening to these freaking clowns out there. Thank you and bye-bye. Like, subscribe.